This is just some of my documentation, it's not all of it, about, I got three lectureships in late 2010 to teach at the University of Paris, where I had taught before years and years and years ago, and everything was fine. This time, however, the pay had been cut in half, and things were very chaotic, and I had one lectureship in Nanterre and two in Ville-Tonneuse. I haven't been paid forever for any of them. It's now 2012, and I'm getting the runaround from all over. I've written to all kinds of people. I've sent things, registered mail, email. You know, I didn't even get a contract for Nanterre in any formal form. I just got an attestation, which is, I think in English that would be affidavit, well after I had started teaching. And it says it's for 36 hours. It gives their address. It's got a stamp on it. See, if I work for you as an expatriation consultant, if I help you get work or study or live here or even visit here, you know, I go through all this stuff. And this is just outrageous. And I called a few days ago to Nanterre. I spoke to a woman, a Madame Guillaume, in traitement. And she said that the matter, the dossier, which had disappeared, but it has apparently been found, is in the hands of Madame Ashash Nadia, whom I met with Mr. Cornelius Crowley on the 19th of January, 2011, and they both assured me that I would be paid in February of 2011. Now, when you're a visiting professor here in France, you only get paid twice a year from Éducation Nationale, and the labor courts don't apply if you have a problem here. I think it's only once a year for the university system in Italy. That's what I've heard. And so they never paid me. And for Ville-Tonneuse, I didn't even get a work contract until July, March of 2011. It wasn't executed and returned to me until July of 2011. And basically, really nobody has answered me, except this one guy, Alain Venezia. He said, well, the problem is we don't have your RIB, which is like this bank. See, they won't cut you a check here. They'll do it only by wire transfer. He said, you gave us one for your savings account, and we need one for your checking account. So I sent him one for the checking account, and he said also a copy front and back of your French ID and stuff. And he had said before, you know, well, we don't have all the documentation, and actually my husband wrote this for me in French, which he hates to do. He gets very angry with me when he has to do this sort of thing. And I retyped it or rewrote it and sent it. And I said, I don't really know why you're asking for new copies of my diplomas. I've already worked for you and gotten paid. And in fact, here are copies of, you know, the stuff that the university accepted years before. Nothing has changed. I'm still the same person. I live in the same place. You know all that. So if it seems to you that I charge a lot for expatriation services, and some of you have actually complained, I want to let you know that I lose half of whatever I charge you to taxes and social charges. I declare my income in France. I declare my income in the United States. And it's very, very hard work to get stuff done for you. It requires tremendous legwork, a lot of babysitting, a lot of teaching, a lot of hands-on stuff. You know, I just don't let you fall through the cracks. But I want you to see that for myself, for my own life, and I've been living here since 1994, it is just so hard to get basic things such as pay taken care of for what's supposed to be a respectable institution such as l'Éducation Nationale in France. So, believe me, if you hire me, I fight for you. I fight for myself, and I fight for my clients, and that's it. All right, thanks for listening. Bye.